Once you understand the basics of elevator recall and the requirements, it's pretty easy to program. We will set up a basic system utilizing VeriFire Tools by Notifier. Having a plan before you start programming will make this process much simpler. Here we set up a sheet that's going to have standard zones that we're going to use to link the inputs and outputs. We use group 80 for main recall. 83 is going to be our shunt trip, but we're going to use a logic zone for delay. Have our smoke hatch, and we're going to use a CBE column 1 to disable particular outputs and inputs based on where the devices are. Once you have your base project created, I'm going to start at the ACS programming, get our disable switches programmed to bypass the elevator control modules, the shaft and machine room, and the elevator lobby detectors. Now we'll go to our input devices or detectors, and we've already programmed a few things here. In CBE1 are those zones that we're going to be using for bypass. And now we got to program the specific output for each detector based on which zone and therefore control module we want to activate. For the basement detector, we want to trigger main recall or send the elevator to the main, so we'll put in zone 80. The first floor is going to get zone 81, which will send it up to the alternate landing. And we'll fill in the other floors, as you can see. All those floors are getting main recall. The machine room is going to get alternate recall to send it to the alternate landing. The pit will get main recall. And so will the smoke hatch, or the top of the shaft. With the basic recall groups programmed, now we can do the special function groups. So the machine room detector, we want it to blink the elevator hat, so we'll do 82. Same thing for the heat detector. For the heat detector, we need zone 83 to do the shunt trip. The heat detector in the elevator pit also needs to activate the blinking fire hat and shunt trip. And the smoke detector at the top of the hoistway will also blink the hat and do the smoke hatch, zone 84. Now we'll move on to the output modules. You'll see that we've already programmed in zone 180 and CBE1 column, so the bypasses will work. And now we just need to put the individual control zones on each module. Remember, main is zone 80, alternate 81, blinking hat 82, shunt trip. Now remember, we're going to do a time delay, so we're going to use a logic zone for that. And that's going to be ZL83, and then our hatch is zone 84. Finally, come over to your logic equations. You can use the builder or you can just type it in manually. So we're going to do a delay, DEL, for 0 hours, 0 minutes, and 30 seconds. You'd coordinate this with the elevator contractor. You may need to time the elevator from top to bottom. The second part of the timing here is how long you want the relay to stay on. If you want it to stay on indefinitely, you just put it all wildcard stars. And then we're going to apply this to input zone 83. And we'll label this as shunt delay, and then we should be good to go.